The problem is with use. It's with how people use the product. 65% of Brits admit to overfilling their kettle when they only need one cup of tea. All of this extra water that's being boiled requires energy. And it's been calculated that in one day of extra energy use from boiling kettles is enough to light all of the street lights in England for a night.
I'm Jasmina and that is Nils, and we finished our studies here in Design Academy Eindhoven in the department activity. Right now we are taking part of the graduation show upstairs, and we are establishing our own studio, which is called Chudy and Jasmina in our own surnames. And actually right now we are based in Denmark, although Nils is German and I'm Latvian, and we're educated here for different reasons. Now we decided to move to Copenhagen.
What was your research method in the earlier stage?
At the beginning, it was very broad, so I tried to look into every single thing that was out there. I came across electric kettles, and I noticed they all have the sense of motion in them. They're either high-speed trains, or they look like crappy renders. They're all the same. And then when I went a little deeper into them, I saw that they have a fundamental design problem, which means you don't know how much water can be put inside. There's always this little measurement on the side, but everyone always overfills them. And there's a really nice quote by Leila Akaroglu who says, "One day of extra energy use from overfilling electric kettles in the UK is enough to light all the streetlights in England for a night." So when I heard that quote, I knew there was something that needed to be changed about electric kettles, and that's the thing that I tried to do with the graduation project.
Could you tell us something about men and activity?
I think men activity is right now very, very broad department, and in general I think in the school the departments are more divided, how I see it, not by the end result, but more the way how you get to the end result. Also now when you walk through the graduation show, you look at activity, it's both fabrics, industrial appliances and proteases, how do you pronounce that?
Proteases.
And then ceramics, and then it's very everything. But what is always common for all the projects is that you have to be able to answer the questions for what it is, why do you make it, and that's really activity, because you can end up with whatever kind of thing, and you can tell these beautiful stories of the makers or whoever, but you have to be able to reply these concrete questions that it makes sense to actually make it. And it has to function. The doors has to be able to close, the stool has to be able to hold the person, it can't be too uncomfortable. So that's what I see is really activity. And the end result, you can make it how you want it.
So it's also a lot about the process.
Very much, but that's the school in general.
Yeah. The process is super important. So at the beginning you start from a very wide range, your inspiration is very broad, but then you start to narrow down more and more to get something that you really want. But this whole process, it's really extended. You make a lot of models in between, a lot of sketches, a lot of drawings, you get a lot of feedback from a lot of different people. So this process part, it's really what the school is all about, and of course activity as well.
So in the end, can you give some suggestions for design students?
Don't be scared, try out everything. Yeah. It's fun. It's going to be hard. Super hard.
And try to go for the things that you think you can't do. And try to solve these things. Also try to go for the things you think you're not so good at. And try to conquer those. Those are the things you're going to learn from most.
And that's what's going to stay in mind. Not the things that I stayed in my comfort zone, I just did because I knew how to do it. The things when you're like, wow, I actually learned this thing, so cool. That's the things you then remember when you're out of the school, like,
and when you, You're in a safe zone here, nothing can happen. The only thing is that you can happen is that you repeat half a year at the Design Academy, and it's a great university. You're going to learn even more. So just try things that you don't think you're capable of, and just go for it.
And even the falling back, it's not always a bad thing.
No, absolutely
we see so
not.
Many friends who were so sad when they fell off, but then afterwards they realize that it didn't make sense, because then you see how much better you actually could do because they threw you back 1.5 year. Of course it hurts like hell, but then you see yourself, there is always a bit of reason. And I mean, why not? It's just half year more and doing fun stuff that you actually love.
Yeah, being in a safe environment, not worrying about too much, and just working on what you love to do, it's great.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.